Good morning, dear students. How are you? I think you are well. You are staying at home. I also think you are enjoying online class and you are studying at home. In our last class, we learned some rules of right form of verbs and right form of verbs on present indefinite tense. Today we shall learn some rules of right form of verbs and right form of verbs on present continuous tense, present perfect tense and present perfect continuous tense. Let's start learning. Now look at the whiteboard and write down the topic right form of verbs. Write down. I think you have written. Now look at the sentence. I to I am to write a letter. To write within bracket and in present continuous tense we have learned that after am, is, are, verb takes ing. So according to present continuous tense we can learn I am, I am writing a letter. So another sentence like this one, a letter is to write in bracket full stop. Now look at the sentence. Here in this sentence structure is subject plus is plus to write, but here we shall not add ing to write because this is passive voice. The sentence is in passive form. So we shall write here a letter is past participle written. Written. A letter is written. This is passive voice. Now there is a difference between these two sentences. You should mark carefully. Here structure, both of the sentences have same structure. Subject plus auxiliary verb plus main verb. In the second sentence there is also a subject plus auxiliary verb plus main verb. But here the first sentence is in active voice and there is a object in this sentence. If there is a object in present continuous tense or in any tense, then we shall use active active voice, then the structure will be subject plus auxiliary verb plus main verb with ing plus object plus extension. And here subject is active. In the second sentence, the structure is subject plus auxiliary verb plus main verb. But here the object of the first sentence, a letter, has been the subject of this sentence. And here the object has become the subject of this sentence. And the object is here active. But the subject of the first sentence is absent in the second sentence. We can also write, to write by me. But by me or by plus any kind of object will be omitted most of the time in passive voice. But how will you know that the sentence is passive? You should mark that in the passive sentence, object is usually absent. Object is usually absent. Here in this sentence, there is no object. If the sentence has no object, then we can think that the sentence is in passive form. Then the structure will be subject plus auxiliary verb plus past participle. Now, we can learn the rules of right form of verb. I am writing the rules. You can also write now. If there is now, at this moment, at present, in any sentence, then we can use present continuous tense. As for example, I can write a sentence, the boy does get to read a book now. Here in this sentence, there is now, and now indicates present continuous tense. And you can notice that in this sentence there is no auxiliary verb, but now indicates that the sentence will be in present continuous tense. So according to a structure, we can write the boy structure subject plus auxiliary verb am is are, the boy is main verb with ing, reading a book now. The boy is reading a book now. I think you have understood. And if there is at this moment, at present, in any sentence, then we shall use present continuous tense for the right form of verbs. Now, write down the sentences. I think you have written the first two sentences. Now, we can write right form of verbs on present perfect tense, and if there is, you can write down, if there is just now, already, recently, lately, even of late, in any sentence, then we shall use present perfect tense. We shall use present perfect tense. Just now, already, recently, lately, ever, of late. These are adverbs. And if there is any of these adverbs in any sentence, then we shall use present perfect tense. Now I am citing an example for you. He to do the work just now. He to do the work just now, and there is just now, which indicates present perfect tense. So you can use the structure of present perfect tense. According to the structure, we can write subject plus have oblique has. We already learned that for third person singular number subject, we use has. Then we can write has. If the subject is third person singular number, then has is used. Subject plus has plus past participle done plus extension. The work just now. He has done the work just now. Subject plus auxiliary verb plus past participle plus extension. In this way, if there is just, already, recently, lately, in any sentence, then we shall use present perfect tense. Write down the sentence. I think you have written and you have understood. Now, write form of verb on present perfect continuous tense. Present perfect continuous tense. She to memorize. She to memorize a poem for an hour. She to memorize a poem for an hour. And we learn that if there is cause or since plus any kind of time, then the sentence is present perfect continuous tense. And the sentence has also for plus time, and for plus time indicates present perfect continuous tense. And according to the structure of present perfect continuous tense, we can write subject plus have been oblique has been. Subject plus has been oblique has been. Now we can write subject plus has been. Subject third person, so has been. She has been. Subject plus has been, object has been, plus main verb with ing, memorizing. Memorizing plus extension. A poem for an hour. I repeat, if the sentence has for oblique since plus any kind of time, then according to the present perfect continuous tense, we can write or we shall write subject plus have been oblique has been plus main verb with ing plus extension. Now write down the sentence. I think you have written, and today our time is almost finished, and I think you will study or read these rules at home. I already told you that the rules of right form of verbs are very essential to any kind of grammar. I can also say that these rules will help you to complete sentences, that is to completing sentences and to gap filling and other kinds of verb. So it's your duty to learn or read the rules of right form of verbs at home. Don't waste time in vain. You have now enough time. You can read at home, and this is all. Thank you all.